Start.
Hello everyone, myself Yamini Patil. Today in this video we are going to cover introduction to SEO. Now if we listen the term SEO, it related to the search engine, it related to the internet. Basically when we talk about the SEO, these are the basic terms about the internet or any marketing strategy. Nowadays for every small thing we are performing the searches, whether it is an intentional search or non-intentional search. Nowadays users perform search for every single second. If we see the statistics, that time Google has performing searches or giving the responses to the searches, that is 3000 million per second. Google is one of the dominant search engine nowadays in market. There are many search engines are available. Many search engines like Google is one of the prominent, we can say. Next is Yahoo is there, Bing is there. For different countries they are having their own search engines also, like China is having their own search engine, North Korea is having their own search engine. That is the importance of search is day in our day-to-day life. We can say that search is an integral part of our society, because if your business is on internet and it is not present on search engine results, then you are out of the business. We can say directly like that, because whenever a person is searching for any resources, any product, any information, and it is related to your business and it is not available on internet, that is the biggest drawback for your business, we can say that. So why we are moving to the SEO? Now SEO is nothing but the search engine optimization. If we talk about search engine optimization, these are the basic factors of search engine optimization. We can do the analysis, we can do the competitive analysis of different websites. Then we have site architecture, how our website should be seen or visible to our consumers or the customers, that is important. Next is the content. Only website doesn't matter, what content is in your website is present, that matters a lot. So content is a whole and soul an important aspect of the search engine optimization. Next point is backlinks is there, index and keywords are there. Keywords also plays a very vital role in SEO, because the search is performed through the keywords only. Next is the ranking, how we are getting the rankings, which page is getting more ranking, which page is getting low ranking, having very good content on that particular page, that is also important. Next is the traffic. Traffic is nothing but how much traffic, how many number of users are coming to your website, that is related to the traffic. Now we are having different techniques to apply SEO, that is on page SEO is there, off page SEO is there, and mostly it is related to the internet. How we are going to grow on the internet, like in the business sense, in the marketing sense, that is really really applicable through the search engine optimization. Now when we are talking about SEO, two terms are important. What is SEO? Why we should use SEO? Because before SEO, before internet, business were going very well, markets are going very well, companies used to earn lot of money through their business. Why now suddenly there is a need of internet, there is a need of SEO? Why we should be present on a internet? That is given, answer is given by SEO. SEO is stands for search engine optimization. It is an online marketing technique which helps you to show your website on top of the search engine results. Now what is this search engine results? Whenever we go to the any particular search engine, like we are using Google, we put some keywords, that is iPhone. I want to buy one iPhone. In the query box I'll put the query iPhone. So I will get certain a list of results, that is first I'll get Apple website, then I'll get Amazon website, then I'll get Flipkart website, then I'll get eBay website. Wherever the iPhone is about to sell, I will get all this listing. On that listing, where your website is ranking. If I am the owner of Amazon, I will say that I want my website should be on the top. For that, I should having the hitting technology over there. How I will bring my website on the top of the result, that for all the results, we are making use of SEO. Now, why is SEO? Because okay, internet is there, my business is there, why there is a special need of SEO? Basically SEO provides a greater visibility to your business. It will show your business on the various aspects on the internet. Next is that to get more traffic. Traffic is nothing but the how many number of users are visiting to your website, that how much time they are spending on your website, is they are doing any transaction on your website. That is all related to the traffic, the number of users coming to your website. Next is that easy way to show your business as a brand. Now when we are having a business, SEO helps you, whether your business is a small scale business, it will help you to make it as a brand. Because nowadays in this information era, we want that our business should be a brand. So how to make it as a small scale business also as a brand, SEO definitely help in that. Now, whenever applying the basic SEO, basics of SEO or strategies of SEO or some technique of SEO, we must be knowing of what is search engine, how search engine actually works. Now, day to day we are performing many searches. Okay, for every single seconds we are performing searches. Now, how that search engine works, how search engine performs, that we will see in the next slide. This is the way, that is how search engine works. Nowadays, many websites are already launched on internet. That is, some are old websites are there every day, every seconds. Many new websites are launching on website. Now, whenever any user puts a query to a search engine, the search engine crawlers or the spiders, which are the automatic programs or the codes, they will crawl through your source code of your website and store that source code on the local server for their performing the different operation. Now what will happen, whenever a crawler or a spider go through that particular source code, it will not read the complete website, it will read the certain tags of your and as of we all know, website are coded into the HTML, CSS, JavaScript, which these are the basic language or full stack are there. So how they are going to read this code? So they are going to read the complete information about your particular website, particular about the code, but they will not go through the logic or the intentional code behind that particular code or the website. So they store it to the local server. Once that data is stored at the local server, indexer will provide index to the all information, means it will distribute the information into the different tags, like hotel websites are stored at one places, hospital websites are stored at one places, school related information will be stored at the different places. All these indexes are stored on the main server. After that, whenever user puts any query to the web browser, it will show the results of that particular query. How these results will show, how the ranking of that particular website will be done, it will be done through the ranking algorithm. There are various ranking algorithms are present. Basically, some of them ranking algorithms are based on the keywords and the tags which is used in that particular website, matching to the user's query, and upon that they will decide the search engine's result page, which website should be present on the top, which website should be present on the second or third. Likewise, they will give the indexes, they will perform the ranking for that particular topic. Now we will move on to the how is search engine process. Search engine optimization process is compliance of the very different processes, like we have website analysis, client requirements, keyword research, content writing, website optimization, SEO submission, link building and reporting. Including all these things are complete one SEO process. These are the basic one, we can add on the other ones as per our website requirement. Now if I talk about website analysis is nothing but when we decide that okay, for my business I want to launch my website, first what I'll do, I will do the competitive analysis. Means what I'll do, first I'll take the my website topic and I'll search related the competitors' website. I will check out their website, I will take the important points from their website. According to that I will decide my client requirements. After that, next point is client requirements. After the competitive analysis, we'll go to the client requirements. Client requirements is nothing but from the client we will take which points they want to highlight, where they want to hit their website, whether they want to hit their website in a state, in a country or international level. According to that we will give their hitting ratio. According to that, we will select their policies or the strategies. Next is that the keyword research. Now every business has some keyword, whether it is an online business or an offline business, some keyword is associated to that particular business. If my business is related to the fabrics, my company is producing three different kinds of fabrics for ladies, for gents and for kids. So mostly I will be having the three main keywords, that is the ladies garments, gents garments and the kids garment. This would be the my three basic keywords. According to that, I will vary my secondary level keywords, like traditional clothing for kids, traditional clothing for men, traditional clothing for women. Likewise, I can divide my keywords on the secondary and the third level also. So keyword research is also important aspect of the SEO, because keywords are related to the user's query. Users is going to be provide that particular keyword. Next topic is content writing. It is really important for the SEO, because launching a website just with the keywords is not sufficient. Our content also matters a lot, because if the repetitive content is present on each page of my website, user will get bored and he will not attain, he will not spend more time or he will not do any kind of transaction on my website, because the same content he is visiting on each web page. So according to the keywords for each web page, you should write the content for that particular page. Content should not be repeated in your website. Next is a website optimization. How you will do the website optimization? Similarly, duplicate content should not be there. Multiple links should not be provided for the same information or for the same keyword. For a single keyword, only single web page should be open, not more than two web page should be open for a single keyword. There are certain guidelines are provided by the SEO, so for website optimization. Next is the SEO submission. How we are providing the SEO submission, that guidelines also provided by the SEO optimization. Next is the link building, which is very, very important. Why? Because we get the backlinks. Whenever any particular website is giving link to our website, that goes to the positive side according to the SEO. Means if we see Wikipedia or we are and different other website who are just providing the information, that time they will provide you the source of that particular information, they will provide you the link. If it is going to the another website, that website having the positive side, that is Wikipedia is giving backlink to my website. So link building is very, very important aspect in the SEO process. Next is the reporting. Reporting is one of the important aspect, we can say, in the sense of we can make use of different tool, like Yahoo Analytics is there, popular is the Google Analytics. From that we will can generate different kinds of reports, like how from which location my website is visiting more, which browsers they are using, which age group is accessing my website is more, how many time a single user is coming to my website, how much transaction he has performed, how much bounce rate is having per user. That all kinds of reports can be generated by the different tools. Now we'll see to the next level for the SEO. That is the, these are the two techniques, that is on-page optimization and off-page optimization are the two techniques from where we can make use of SEO. Now if we talk about on-page optimization, on-page optimization is mainly concerned about the content, link building, keyword analysis, whatever present on your website. Basically which user is going to be see, that that is nothing but the on-page optimization. First is a keyword analysis. You have to go through the each and every keyword of your website which is visible or which is visible on that particular web page, how it is going to be accessed by the user, how it is going, how much traffic it is generated that particular keyword, that we have to show. After that, next is competition of website analysis. We have, whenever we do the optimization, we always have to aware about what our competitors are doing. So whenever you are doing on-page optimization, that time you should be always aware, always go through the competition website analysis, what they are providing. You should not be providing the same thing on your website. Okay, so you should be do something better. Whenever I give you example, that is when I want to buy iPhone, my first website is coming Apple, second is coming Amazon, third is coming Flipkart. So Flipkart will always look for why Amazon is getting so much hitting for the iPhone, why I am not getting. So for this kind of competition analysis for website should do and try to put their website on the higher level. Next is a tag optimization. We are having meta tag optimization in the code where the web crawlers basically take the information from that particular website. Head tag is there. Which tags are used by the crawlers, we should optimize them properly into the source code so more and more crawlers can take the information from our website and we will hit on the topmost position. Next is a web speed optimization. When web speed optimization, nothing but how much load time is giving by your website. If your website is full of with the images or the sliders, if its loading time is more, user will opt for the another next result. So this will goes to the negative point. Through the SEO point of view. So we want that our website should be used quickly, so website loading speed should be minimum. How to optimize that? That is also comes into the on-page optimization. Next is the CSS JavaScript file optimization. The when CSS JavaScript file optimization is there, that time we have to see CSS and JavaScript are the large files, so how we can optimize so the loading time will be the minimum. Next we have to see the text code ratio. Text code ratio is nothing but in your whenever source code is there, in source code textual information is not more or not even less. So various tools are available where you can access through how much text code ratio should be keep for your website. Last not the but the least, that is link building is the very much important aspect for the on-page optimization. How much links you are getting to your website means your website name or URL is present on others website, that is really really important and the positive aspect or a point for the SEO point of view. So link building is very very important. After that, how much link you are providing to the other website, that is also one aspect. These are the different techniques are present for on-page optimization. Now we'll go for the off-page optimization. Off-page optimization is nothing but to increase the search engine ranking for our keywords. Basically, it is used to build backlinks to the other website. But when we can use off-page optimization, when you are completely doing the on-page optimization, means 90% of your on-page optimization is done, then and then you can start for the off-page optimization. Okay, in that different techniques are directory submission, social bookmarking, article submission, social media, blog commenting, photo sharing and guest posting. Directory submission means for the different search engine we will submit our website to them, our data to them. So whenever for that particular website query is coming, our website should be visible to that particular search engine. So directory submission is one is off-page optimization, we can say. Social bookmarking is different between the there is a difference between social bookmarking and social media. Social bookmarking means how many other social bookmarkings are getting to your website. Okay, so that way you can see how off-page optimization is getting means if I am posting something on my social media to related my business, do I get any social bookmarking then, or any other website are making use of my website on social media? That we have to see through the social bookmarking. Next is the article submission. Article submission is nothing but if sometimes any information related website is there, how to use that particular tool or any machine, that time if we have given the article and that article particular your website is showing, they are providing their link, then it comes to the article submission. Next is the social media. How much your website is active on the social media, that counted. Next is a blog commenting. Various bloggers are there, they are using different website for different using tools or for any transaction or for any information. If they are mentioning your website in the blog commenting, that time it is a positive sign for your website. Photo sharing. For photo sharing means nowadays if we see when we go to the Google Images or Pinterest, that time different only images is the images is the prime part. From that image, if you are going to that particular website, that is also a plus point, we can say. In photo sharing, Pinterest is the topmost, then we can make use of Google Images also. So by making use of images which is present in our website, that also count one kind of optimization technique. Next is a guest posting. Guest posting means someone is coming to your website, they are posting about your website, they are giving different links of your website on other website, so that count as a positive point. So here in this video we have seen that what is basic of search engine, how to apply the search engine, what are the different aspects of search engine, and two main techniques of search engine optimization, that is on-page optimization and off-page optimization. Thank you.